Testing, testing, testing that audio. Just getting set up here, so I'm not quite in the zone yet. Making sure people can hear my audio properly. Can everyone hear me? Thanks, everybody. Is the music good or is it distracting? Thank you, Nate. Let me know if you have any questions. I think it shows up on ArtStation. It should be streaming there. Let me check. There's a link that should show up in there. This is the first time I ever used it though, so I'm not positive. Is it showing up in that list? Awesome, thanks. Yeah, I always forget it even exists. This is the first time I used it, and although I haven't really streamed much either, so. Are you an ArtStation regular as well? I do a 3D. First I do a basic sketch, which I might be able to pull up just on traditional. Let me see if I can find it. Whoops. Yeah, so here's the original sketch. Yeah, so there's the basic sketch, and sometimes I'll just use that and paint over it. Sometimes I'll use 3D and kind of play around with the lighting and stuff. In this case, I actually changed the composition. Well, I changed the composition a little bit. Kind of went for more of an above view. Right now, I'm trying to find some good reference for leaves and jungle plants. I swear I need a third screen. It's so hard to have reference up, paint, and have a chat window open. Just working on breaking up these edges with some grass. My favorite part is kind of this part where the light passes over, so you can kind of have this mixture of darker grass right behind it, or like right here. Kind of these darker lines. And then just some brighter strands of grass right behind that. I use a bunch of layers. Sometimes I've done the one layer thing, but like right now I'm kind of... Sometimes I use layers just so I can kind of break down the process. Like I have all this grass built up here, all the vines down another layer here, another few just passes of light and stuff. It's like a texture layer. I sort of just keep building up on top with new layers on top of things. More to just kind of save the object in different layers instead of just making it easier on myself. Sometimes I use it for selections, like I'll go back to the initial base and do a quick selection of when it was more solid object shape, so I could do like a selection of maybe this whole doorway here or something like that. Are you a concept artist as well? Kind of just build the grass up from the back forwards. See a nice natural layering. No, I don't use Twitch too much. I want to, I just kind of... I guess it's a little bit intimidating. I've probably only used it maybe 3 times in the past. How about yourself? Do you use it very often? Twitch fiend. Are you putting content out, or are you a consumer of Twitch? Oh, really? I'd love to watch that. I'm pretty into the game dev stuff as well. Hey Dylan, or Critical Mammal. Yeah, watching painting while painting would be perfect, isn't it? Yeah, I've done that quite a bit. It's very inspirational to watch other people paint. Sometimes I kind of fall in the habit of just like watching Let's Plays and stuff of games, which is fun and all, but it feels like my mind is a little more slogged down. I don't know if that's the right term for that, but it's kind of slower. In my day job, I am in a studio with other people, but nobody says anything. So I think Twitch might even be more accurate, or more like a real studio, I guess. I don't know. Is anyone familiar with, like, copyright laws? Can you just play music in the background? Does that matter? Yeah, you can learn a ton from watching people paint. It's awesome. Oh, so if you save them out to post them somewhere else. Yeah, that makes sense. I think I'll wait to save them and when I'm actually better at streaming, maybe. I'm still learning to talk and paint at the same time. Doesn't like YouTube and stuff have a thing where they just automatically the money of views and stuff goes to the content owner? No, wasn't that like a recent addition? Yeah, that's a rough way to discover that. Oh, isn't like listening to your own voice the worst sometimes? Or maybe all of the times? I don't know. For me it is. Yeah, that's pretty much what it comes down to. Acceptance of that weird voice that you really are. Yeah, I suppose maybe you might learn to speak clearer. That's one thing I know I have to work on. I'm a bit of a mumbler. What's that tool? I'm just using Open Broadcasting. Oh, okay, cool. Thanks. I'll check it out. I've I've actually never even asked clients if they would allow me to stream their stuff. Yeah, it's all personal work that I stream. It probably really depends, like, if, say, you're streaming for something that's already announced and out, and it's not, like, gonna be new content, then maybe they could use that as, like, an advertising thing. I know probably the projects I'm working on right now, I have pretty hefty, NDAs, so I can't stream any of that. And I assume if they had me sign an NDA and stuff, they probably wouldn't want me streaming any of that. Think at my day job, they would probably be okay with it. It's a little easier to communicate with them, though. I could ask them if they want to use that as like a promotional tool, maybe. Save. I guess it probably depends how long you've been working with that client and what kind of projects you work on. I work at Kiz Studios. They make mobile games. It's KIZ. And I'm an environment artist there. time for a new layer. I'm gonna do like a moss grass growing up over this stuff. Didn't this song already play? Oh, what's the link for that? The Twitch music. Is anyone else so ingrained with using shortcut keyboard shortcuts that you can't really use like the tablet ones and stuff? I keep trying to switch over because my thumb is literally tired from pressing Alt and Spacebar, but I have such a hard time switching over. Guess I could. Thank you. Yeah, that's what I was attempting to as well. Mainly just my thumb was in pain. I think it's just such an unnatural position for it to be in, sort of sideways. Yeah, it seems like I'm so slow when I use them that I just can't justify sitting there for days trying to figure them out, getting my brain to stop using the keyboard shortcuts. But I suppose wrist pain and such is probably a good reason. I think I just started that music by accident. Yeah, I saw some VR painting that looked really cool. Like kind of painting in 3D. Imagine like a ZBrush program or something. That fidelity with VR would be really cool. Sadly, VR gives me motion sickness. I'll have to be an old timer in the future.
Step up your game, Pixelogic.
This is that the music, the Twitch stream music from Spotify. So maybe a little less relaxing than I want to listen to right now, though. Trying to remember. Oh yeah, Laserhawk. No. Yes, it's super dubstep. Let's see. So many robot ears. I can't think of the band that I wanted to play, so I'll play some Churches. I figure this video's already been deemed copyright issues. If anyone has any questions, feel free to ask. Into the night for once, we're the only ones left. I bet you even know where we could go. It is the exact size of my bedroom. Or do you mean the studio I work for? The studio I work for is
25 people or something like that.
But only two concept artists. Oh, is there a job post there? I have somehow got away with everything. Anything you ever did was strictly by design, but you got it wrong. And I go anywhere but there. And you have best belief that you're gonna build one I don't need. Yeah, there's a, the studio has some offshoots, so that's probably the postings are for. There's like, I think there's an Atlanta branch. There might even be another, I think there's a branch in England too. I actually jump around a lot. I work on like every different project I have. I work on projects that are for all the different branches of the studio. Pretty much whatever needs work done. There's like kind of loosely based teams. Like a primary team, and then kind of jump around from there. Do you do environment art or character art? I'd like to see your work. Yeah, fundamentals are always important. Doesn't matter how far along you are. Have you seen that website, drawbox.com? Yeah, it's, I didn't really realize I could for a long time either. I always liked drawing, but I never really thought I would go anywhere with it. But it's totally a legit career. Oh, you're doing both 3D and 2D environments. Nice. Nice texture work, too. It does take a while. I've been doing it for like over 10 years, I guess. Not professionally, but trying to be professional, I suppose. Kind of understanding because you do it now type thing, or do you mean just like seeing what's in the world? It definitely helps with that. I know when I was in undergrad, I didn't even know concept art existed as a career until maybe the end of my schooling. And even then, I didn't pursue it. Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure. Working on 3D stuff's really relaxing for me. More so than painting, honestly. Yeah, kind of like, how would you recreate that in 3D? It can't possibly exist in 3D space. Yeah, it's good to like make your own concepts and then wait a while and then work off those concepts and see kind of where you faltered, what doesn't really make sense. I've only done a little bit of 3D work though. Fill this up with something back here, but I can't quite decide what. I was thinking a vine and then some stuff growing on it, but can't quite get it to look right. I wonder if I still have my flip. Oh yeah, flip. I don't know if I have my flip canvas. There it is. Made an action out of it. Wait, F2? Don't you have to set that shortcut up or no? I just have it set up as an action. Yeah, I'm using Creative Cloud. Finally bit the bullet and got the monthly subscription of it. Has some pretty cool tools in it though. It's a lot easier paying a monthly fee instead of, was it like $800 or something? Yeah. After a few years, though. But you get all the updates, so. I kind of prefer the monthly subscription. The 3D tools in Photoshop are pretty nice now, too. Sometimes I'll use those. Make like a base of a concept or something. I can understand getting upset if I had like just purchased it, maybe. But yeah. the one thing is weird. You, like, paying... There's no difference in paying monthly or all of it in a lump sum of the 120. And you have to get it for a full year subscription, so that's a little bit weird. So basically it is 120 a year no matter what you do. I don't know, you might be able to add features for a month at a time if you have like a base setup, so maybe you could get like Premiere like you're saying for a month or whatever, but I'm not sure if that's the case or not. Yeah. I thought they'd at least give you a deal for getting it for a full year, like maybe a slight discount off the normal price, but nah. It's just 120 no matter what. I was looking into options to edit videos and stuff, maybe make some tutorials and whatnot, but and everyone suggests Premiere, so I'll have to look into that and see how that works out. How long has everyone been doing art for? Thank you. Has everyone here watched Stranger Things yet? So good. I haven't heard of Vegas? Huh. Yeah, I probably wouldn't be doing too much advanced things. Basically just audio and some cuts and maybe some speed increases and things like that. Yeah, I focus on realistic stuff a lot too. Like, I remember first starting out, everyone just, my school was just all about kind of recreating photos, so that's what I tried doing for a long time, and I realized, I was like, what's the point of this, like, it's just, you're just taking a photo that already exists and then making a drawing of it and trying to replicate that as much as possible. There's really no outcome that's that different or anything. Yeah, after finishing Stranger Things, I felt, like, so empty because I didn't know what else to watch. I ended up watching Humans, which was pretty good. Not as good as Stranger Things, for sure, but I guess they did announce another season as well, which is exciting. A lot of people were guessing that the next season would be a whole new cast, but I guess it's going to be the same cast. So we will see what happens there. Yeah, thanks. Yeah, let me know when you're streaming. I'd like to see it. Take care, and thanks for stopping by. I'll try streaming more often. Yes. What's a good playlist to go along with Stranger Things? Not the like the musical ones, but more of the synth stuff. So you want to have some suggestions I could play? Take care. And thanks. Let's try this out, Starcade.
You guys are gonna go back in time. Woo! Let's go.
Are you gonna get No Man's Sky? I was gonna try it out this weekend. I will be right back.
gonna be here. We're gonna get wide and have a big party.
Okay, I'm back. This needs some flowers, maybe? A little more overgrowth here. I'm getting pretty excited about No Man's Sky now. Originally, I wasn't so sure. Well, originally, I was super excited about it. But then I wasn't sure if it's, like, too survival-based. I've always thought it looked beautiful art-wise. I just started following the artists on ArtStation. I'm not sure. I'll see if I can find their link. Their work. Yeah, I'll find it later. Brighten up this pillar a little bit. A little bit of overlay. Thank you. Yeah, I love that kind of very basic geometry shapes used as architecture. I guess I didn't even think there'd be that much architecture in there. Probably hard to do a lot of overgrown stuff with such a heavily procedurally based game, maybe? Yeah, this is pretty heavily overgrown. Probably even for my stuff. I don't think I've done a ton of this type of work. A lot of the architecture stuff, but... Are the creatures and everything, are those also randomly created? Or procedurally to some degree? I saw some crazy picture today where it was just like this huge creature with tiny little wings flying around. Oh yeah, I was gonna add some flowers to this. Thank you. Now I gotta choose that flower color. Mushrooms? I could do some mushrooms. What kind of mushroom should I put in there? Give me a mushroom reference. Strange. They look like jelly or jam or something. They have kind of a white base, sort of orangey. Make a layer for them. Let's see if they look any good in here. They're really strange.
Bleeding tooth fungus? That's the worst name ever.
I can just replicate them right in here. I think they're strange enough that they won't look out of place. Normally I always steal like glowy mushrooms, but I think this will look cool. Wrong brush. Oh yeah, that would be interesting. So many little dots. That's a good idea. Let's get this little fuzzy bits under here. They have like little beards, neck beards. The neck bearded mushrooms. Who doesn't like a neck-bearded mushroom? Called a bleeding tooth or whatever.
frills. That'd probably be a more appropriate name than neckbeards.
Should I keep the little beads red, or should I
shift them to a different color?
You can change them from strawberry jam, you could go blueberry jam. Greenberry jam. Anyway, green, I think there's so much other green, you're not gonna really stick out that much. Very frightened to change the base color. This is the most important decision in the painting, the mushroom color. What color of sprinkles do these mushrooms get? Yeah, I guess that kind of neon green is kind of interesting. I could brighten it up a bit. Do a little bit of a vignette. Tasty glowing sprinkles. Few dust bits. Thank you. motion blur on them. Maybe not on those. Maybe a little bit of fog. Too splotchy. Yeah, it does. It's my banana brush. Use for all my bananaing needs. It's like a cloud shape, sort of like a... sort of like a banana. maybe some light shafts, maybe. I think it's almost done. Gotta sign it. Color balance layer. Whoa. Taking in the red spectrum maybe a little tiny bit. Warm it up. Or cool it down a little. I might cool it down a little bit. Yeah, definitely cool it down a little bit. Oh, that'd be pretty cool. What do you guys think? Warmer or cooler? Bring up the heat. It's pretty hot. Sharpen it and add some noise. I think it's done. Yeah, I'd say that's done. anyone wants to check out, I have a Patreon. Let me get that link. There's my Patreon. It's just patreon.com/randomspirits. I would appreciate any sort of help there to do more paintings and feed the cat. Don't worry, he won't starve. Mushrooms on the steps to the far left look bright. Far left. Oh, those down there. Oh, you know what? I totally forgot to flip this back. I think I liked it better the other way. Oh man, now I don't know. Let me check them out really quick. Mushrooms. Lights. Yeah, my eyes did too. Oh, there they are. Mushrooms. Is it the... mushrooms themselves, or just kind of like they're... I guess, yeah, they're a little... should be a little bit more in shadow, maybe. Good call. I guess I better re-sign this now. I think it's done. I don't know if I like this way or the other way better now. Oh my god, you're picky. No, just kidding. I guess I could try a transparent. I usually don't. It is less distracting. I might have to agree with you again. Bloop. I don't have a schedule yet. I'm just starting out. But I should get a schedule. I guess it depends on what the best time. It'd probably be sometime in the evening. I will have to set up a schedule, though, for sure. Are there any particular times that would probably work for most people? I'm thinking sometime after 6. Maybe, like, that's Eastern time, so, like, maybe 7. and I'd probably do it on maybe Thursdays or Wednesdays. I'm just taking this off the top of my head, though. All the time. I feel like I need a few more little. Okay, 5 p.m. I got out of work at 6. I probably could do probably around 6:30 or something. Definitely do need a schedule. But I feel like this is my third stream, I think. But I want to do it more regularly. Yes, Eastern time. Does anyone want to see the before? There's the before. Yeah, I guess 6:30 wouldn't, that'd be 3:30 Pacific time, I think. Well, yeah, let me pull up the way before. I had it open. Oh. And oh. Draw the circle. So there's the original sketch. But yeah, let me know if there's anything anyone would like to see in particular. And yeah, I'll try to get a schedule set up and try to stick to that schedule. That's going to be the tough one. But yeah. Thanks everyone for stopping by. And yeah, it's been fun. I'll probably post... I'll post the layered files and stuff. They'll be on my Patreon. And the... everything else will probably just be on my ArtStation, which is... let me pull that up. There's my art station. There's my Patreon. I'll try to get a schedule set up. But yeah, thanks again. Everyone have a good night. And I feel like I should have an exit saying, but take care. Bye.